Well, hey, this is Brett here, and in this lesson, I want to show you how when you actually get your presentation really working for you, that you can actually predict your income before you even start, all right? So let me tell you this. The key to being able to predict your income comes down to one number only. Can you think of what that is? It comes down to one number only. Once you know this one number, you can predict your income, and everything becomes very, very exciting. It's your conversion rate. The conversion rate is key. And most people struggle with converting more people into customers. So the conversion rate is low. But even if you have a low conversion rate, it still allows you to predict your income. And I can teach you how to increase that rate. But let me just tell you or show you how exciting it is once you do know what your average conversion rate is. So just to be clear, what it means is your conversion rate is the amount of people who buy your product compared to those that don't. So for instance, if on average for every 100 people that watch your webinar, for example, you get 15 sales, then your conversion rate is 15%. 15 people out of 100 buy your program on average, let's say. Most people, sort of go between 5 to 10% on a webinar or a seminar. That's the average, what most people do who don't really know what they're doing, okay? But once you know what your average conversion rate is, it opens up a whole new world to you in terms of income. And I'm going to explain this fully and show you why. And I predict by the end of this video, you're going to be, it's like shaking. You'd be that excited because if you haven't thought about it this way before, you're going to really get an aha moment here in just a minute, okay? Let me explain. Here's how to predict your income. Here's the equation you want to write down, or at least maybe even just mentally do this math. But to predict your income, all you have to be able to do is know or predict or think about how many people you present to per year. Okay, the number of people you present to per year is the first part of an equation to predicting your income. The number of people that you present to every year, multiplied by your conversion rate that we just talked about, multiplied by the price of your program, your product, your service, which I call your solution. Once you can plug those numbers into this equation, you will be able to know what your income projection is. Okay, so that's not too hard to know. Most people know the price of their product or service. If you've been doing presentations, seminars, webinars, workshops, you might have an idea of your conversion rate. And you might also know that how many people you tend to predict to, or at least how many people you would like to present to per year. All right, because this allows you play with that number, and you can really start, getting some exciting numbers coming out. So, for instance, let's say that you plan to speak to, present in front of, do a workshop for, do a webinar for 500 people. All right, that's a good goal to have. And you know that on average you get 10% conversion rate. All right, 10% of people buy your program at $3,000. All right, which leaves you with a income projection of $150,000. Meaning that for every time that you get to present to 500 people, and not all at once, you might do this over a whole year, let's say. Once you know that there's 500 people watching your webinar or your seminar, with a conversion rate of 10%, you actually know how much money you're going to make before you've made it. And so if you speak to only 400 people, you'll know the difference in your income it's going to make. If you speak to 1,000 people, you'll be able to see exactly the difference it's going to make to your income, right? So what it means is this. If you know you are going to generate $150,000, then my question to you right now is this. Here's the question. How much of that money would you be prepared to spend, or we might say invest, in order to get 500 people to your presentation? Because you know that if you get 500 people to see and sit through your presentation, you make $150,000. It's as good as gold. You know your conversion rate, so it's going to happen. So then a lot of people think, oh, I don't have the money to advertise. I don't know how I'm going to get in front of those people. But let's just think about this a more creative way. If we know our conversion rate, we know the price of our product or service, and we know all we need to do is get in front of people, if you answer this question truthfully, how much of that money would you be prepared to spend in order to get 500 people to your presentation? Would you spend $10,000? Would you set aside a marketing budget of $10,000 in order to make $150,000? Now, I'm suspecting, or I'm hoping certainly, that you're nodding your head going, yes, I would. For every $10,000 you spend, if you can get 500 people along to see your presentation, you make $150,000. Why would you not do that? Would you spend $20,000 or $30,000? In truth, you could spend at least $140,000 and still walk away with $10,000 profit. True or true? So you could spend that, right? But let's assume you spend $30,000. That's a big advertising budget. 30 grand is a big advertising budget in anybody's terms. And it would allow you to dominate your market. Isn't that what you really want to do? Dominate instead of struggling, but actually dominate? If you invested 30 grand, then what would that allow you to spend? That would allow you to spend, rather, $60 per attendee. So what could you do? What could you spend $60 on in order just to get somebody to attend your webinar, to attend your workshop, your seminar? $60 could actually be a great investment. You could buy them a ticket to the seminar, let's say, as in their train ticket, their taxi fare, their Uber fare, right? You could send them a package in the mail, including a DVD and CDs maybe, and a big book. And you could do all the sort of branding and marketing to make a big fuss about coming to your presentation. Up to $60 per person, that's quite a big budget per person. And I'm sure you could think creatively about all the things you could send. Send them movie tickets, dinner vouchers perhaps, drink vouchers. You could really spend a bit of time here thinking about what you could do to make an impact on your market so that they actually want to come and see what this presentation is all about. Okay. What could you give worth $60 in order to get an attendee to your presentation? Because for every $60 you invest, think about this, you know you are going to make $300 back. For every 60 you put in, you get $300 back. And the math is, you know, 500 people times $300 equals $150,000. That's where the math comes from. If you get in front of 500 people, on average, they're going to spend $300. Now, they're not all going to spend $300, but the math is, at the conversion rate, ends up being 10% conversion rate, ends up being $150,000. Divided by the attendees, that's $300 per attendee. On average, for every person who comes to the webinar, let's say, you make $300. Doesn't that open up a whole new world to you? Like, it literally allows you to say, you know what, I know my numbers so well, I could put most of that money on a credit card, knowing that it's a calculated investment. Because I know my numbers. So I'll let the bank pay for it, and then I know I'm going to make the money back. Isn't that cool? But it gets even more exciting, because watch this. In my example, I used 10% as the conversion rate, which is the average you should expect, okay? But increase your conversion rate to 21%, which is what I teach. That's what I teach people how to do. If you increase that to just 21%, so nothing else, not the numbers you're going to speak to, not the price of your program, just increase your conversion rate from 10% to 21%, which is really easy to do when you use some of my techniques. Your income projection now goes to $315,000. That's a $165,000 increase in income for no extra effort. You're still doing the same presentation, selling the same product. You just have more people buying it now. And you've got yourself $165,000 in the bank for no extra effort. Isn't that the most amazing concept? It's easier to make more money than not make more money. That's the reality of it, right? So I hope you really get that. This is truly what you can do if you truly harness what I'm teaching here and what you can do, because it's just so powerful to your income. Now, if you'd like to know how you can get up to 21% of people buying, then you might want to look at how I can teach you to do it. Okay, you'll find a link on this page where you can get help from me further, but that would be one of the best investments you ever make. If I can show you how to do that, you can see the massive amount of income you could be making, or the massive increase in income you could be making, just if I can show you how to do that alone. And I can show you how to do much more. But if you want to know how to get up to 21% of people buying your stuff, then seriously, check out how I can help you, because it could literally change your income forever. Okay, so I certainly hope that you might want to check that out, and maybe we actually get to work together on something for you. I'd be very excited if we could. All right, that's it from me for now, and I look forward to seeing you again soon.